Python ideally is a integrated development environment where we can write our program or command. And with this environment, we have a Python interpreter that is a translator that will execute the Python program. This Python interpreter is also called a Python shell, and this Python shell is used in two different modes. First is interactive mode and second is a scripting mode. So let's see what is the interactive mode. So I will type here IDLE, it will pop up this IDLE link. If you don't have, you have to install first, and for installation you can follow my previous lecture. I will click here, it will open Python shell or IDLE, and it is a prompt where we can type our command in an interactive mode. If you want to see the scripting mode, you can open new file and here you can write your complete program and you can execute with the help of run module command. So let's start with the interactive mode first. So this is the very normal question that comes into in our mind, when to use interactive mode. It does not save your code in a file, it is true, but it is suitable for experimenting, immediate feedback and testing. Why? Because if we have a small one command and that we want to execute and we want to see the result, so we can execute, we can check the, we can experiment in an interactive mode, and immediately it will execute and it will show the response. And testing also we can do. Suppose we have a large program and out of that we want to execute a small portion of that program. So we can keep here in an interactive mode and we can execute and then we can see what the code does. While using the interactive mode, we follow some instructions, and these are the things that we have to remember while using the interactive mode. We will discuss one by one. So, first thing that we have to remember while using the interactive mode is prompt. So, whatever the command we are writing or typing in an interactive mode, we have to keep after this prompt. Suppose I am keeping here one variable, and in this variable I am initializing one string, Hello India. So I have completed this command, and now if you want to execute, you can press enter and then it will execute your command. So again you will get a prompt. Next thing that we have to remember, if you want to see the value of the variable, you can just type the name of the variable here and you can press enter. It will show the value of the variable. We also have some other option like print function. Print and pass the name of the variable. But in an interactive mode, we avoid the use of the print function because it is normally used in a file or scripting mode. If you will execute, it will show the result, no error we will get, but it is meaningless. If we are getting the result with the help of using the name of the variable, why we should use this print function? Next thing that we have to remember, the compound statement. Compound statement are those statement that have more than one lines. Suppose we have a paragraph that we want to write in a multiple lines. So we have to type this command in a multiple lines. So I am creating a one variable and I will keep the one paragraph in this variable. Let's see how we can write this paragraph. So hello guys. And now I want to change the line. So if you will change the line, you will see the cursor without prompt. It is indicating that you can continue typing your command. So I can write here one more line statement. We are Indians. Now I can complete my command. I will keep triple quote and I will press enter. So as you will press enter, you will get a prompt again. So means you have successfully executed your command. We also have some other statement. Then those are compound statement like if or if else or elif or for loop or while loop and function, object, classes. These are the compound statement where we have to write more than one lines. Suppose I am taking a one variable a is equal to 10 and I want to use a if condition a is greater than 5, and as I will enter, I will press the enter, then I will get a cursor in a next line. But the situation is different. In the previous statement we got the cursor in the next line without leaving any space, but here we are getting a space without prompt. So the thing is, it is a intent. More in more detail we will discuss in the lecture of if condition or looping statements. So this is the intent, and I will write here a statement and I will continue to add more statements. So I will press enter. So it is asking to write more statement, or if you want to discontinue this statement, so you can again press the enter. So it, you can leave this statement and it will execute your command and it will show the result. So this is the way of writing the compound statement in an interactive mode. Now we will discuss the scripting mode. So let's see what are the things that we have to remember while using the scripting mode. So while using the scripting mode, we have to, first thing we have to remember, the file extension should be .py. Next things, if we are working in a IDLE, we have to run that program with the help of the run module. And if you want to remove the content from the command prompt, there is no option. You have to re-execute that prompt. Then you will be able to remove all these content. First you have to close and then you have to start again. So let's start. So here we can use the new file command and we will be able to create a new file. And again, I'm writing the same statement. Hello India. And I'm printing because here in file mode, we require a print statement to print the value of the variable. So first we have to save. You can use the control S or you can use the this file save command. So here I'm keeping the test and I'm saving on a desktop. And as you will keep here test, and this is the Python extension .py. It will add automatically with this name. You can save here. Now you can, after every time you have to save your program. So after saving, you can run your program with the help of this run module command. So it will show the result on prompt. Already we have written this, so just it is appending our result. If you want to remove, so you have to close first and you can run again. So it will show the your result on a new command prompt. Now we can also execute the scripting mode in a different ways. So let's see how we can execute and how we can create a file. So here I am removing this file and I am creating a new file with the help of the text document. Here you have to change the name of that document and you have to remove the extension. Here you have to keep py extension of this file with this file name and press enter, and then you can accept yes. We will get the different option to open this file. First, you can open in a IDLE mode that we have already discussed, and you can open in a Notepad++ or you can open a Notepad and sub WordPad. I will use a Notepad++, and I will keep here same statement. Hello India, and now I will print. So you can save first and then you can close, or you can keep or remain open. Now if you want to execute this file, you can open a command prompt cmd, and first you have to go to that location. I have created on a desktop. If you have created in a other location, you can go to that location. And you can keep here the name of the file with the extension, and then you can press enter. It will execute your file. So you can see the result here. And we can also create file, this file with the help of other editor, which is a Sublime. And you can remove. And you can type here strg, the same content you can keep here. Okay, so we can save this content and we can execute. So here, just like IDLE, we can also use run command here, but the interface is different. First we have to select the build system. So because I want to use the Python, so I will click on Python. Then I will use this option, build command, and then I will execute. So you can see here, I am getting this result, Hello India. And if you want to add more, so you can add more. So if you will execute, then it will execute. So you can. Oh, first we have to save. Okay, print statement we have to keep here, and then we can execute. So it will show the result, Hello India, we are Indians. So as per our convenient, we can use the different editors. Suppose you are comfortable with the IDLE, you can use the IDLE. If you are comfortable with the Sublime, you can use some Sublime or Notepad++. So generally, we recommend to use the IDLE for the beginners. So for the practice, so IDLE in an introductory mode, it is a good for the beginners. They can do the practice typing the command, and once they will be able to write the complete program, they can use the IDLE in a scripting mode. Also have some other editors or and IDEs like Jupyter Notebook, Spyder. They are the package available in the Anaconda, Eclipse, PyDev, Komodo, NetBeans IDE for Python. These are also some other IDEs that we can use for the Python programming, Visual Studio, and I have demonstrated the use of Notepad++, Notepad, Sublime. So we have different editors. So as per our convenient, we can use these editors. Thank you very much for watching video. If you have any query, you can keep your query in a comment box. And I hope I will answer your query.